Doctor's wife murdered in Bay Village. Drug thieves suspected in bludgeoning.
At the Bay Village Historical Society, the July 4, 1954 murder of Marilyn Shepherd and the arrest and conviction of her husband, Dr. Sam Shepherd, still resonates 60 years later.
It was just such a one-of-a-kind thing, where all the stars aligned to have a handsome guy, his beautiful wife, murdered in her bed, and still no one knows who did it.
I think the people that murdered Marilyn Shepherd should not be permitted to kill your wife, or yours, or yours.
After serving 10 years in prison, Sam Shepherd's conviction was overturned on the basis that sensational coverage of the case prevented him from getting a fair trial.
Aroused from sleep on a downstairs Davenport, Dr. Shepherd ran up the steps to his wife's bedroom at her screams and was knocked unconscious by the murderer.
Shepherd's claim that his wife was murdered by a bushy-haired intruder,
the fugitive,
was the inspiration for the TV show and movie, The Fugitive.
Did you intend to yell not guilty quite that loud, Sam?
I've yelled it ever since I was arrested.
Sam Shepherd died in 1970, and 30 years later, his son filed a wrongful imprisonment lawsuit against the state of Ohio, claiming the murder had actually been committed by a window washer, Richard Eberle. A civil jury found that Shepherd failed to prove his case, but that did not stop the questions about the murder of Marilyn Shepherd.
You know, they have the bushy-haired stranger, the Eberling connection, the unknown DNA in the bedroom. All of this is thrown out into the story, and that's what keeps it alive today.
The historic home of Sam Shepherd's parents, which is where he was arrested 26 days after the murder, was moved in 1984 to Huntington Reservation and is now home to the Bay Arts Organization.
He was having dinner with his parents, who were inside, and the police invited him to come out so they wouldn't embarrass him in front of his parents.
In 1954, it would have been inconceivable to think that somehow the old Shepherd family home would someday bring joy to art lovers in Greater Cleveland. In the days after Sam Shepherd was convicted of killing his wife, his mother committed suicide, and just 11 days later, his father died from a bleeding ulcer.
As part of a unique Shepherd art show in August, Bay Arts is now inviting Clevelanders to share their stories about the notorious case.
Of all the sensationalism of the case, it's still a very serious story of what happened, and there's a lot of things, stories that were not told. It's just sort of this myth, you know, that kind of continues this legend.
Jack Shea, Fox 8 News in Bay Village.